Facebook Nation, how are you? It's Knowledge by Nikki again. I'm Nikki Smith, and I'm going to talk to you all a little bit today about a couple of things. Yesterday, I actually had a talk with an associate of mine who actually owns a professional supply house here in Chicago. They've been open for, probably 30, 40 years. They sell a lot of the ethnic professional supplies. So I was talking to her for a little while, and we always kind of have these conversations, real intense conversations about the industry and where it's going and where she remembers they were and where they are today. So we start talking about the infamous YouTube, or as I call it, YouTube University. So as we started talking about YouTube, things were just kind of coming to me. Things that I've learned from teaching, things that I've learned from talking to people all over the country and abroad, actually, about what YouTube has actually done for our society, good or bad. And as I talked to her, and as I've talked to other stylists, owners, barbershop owners, school owners, everybody in this industry, we all could kind of agree that YouTube has definitely had an effect on our industry. Could we not? We could kind of agree on that, right? But the thing is, I know, and you know, that YouTube isn't going anywhere. It's not going anywhere, guys. YouTube will be here probably longer than we'll be here. It's here to stay. So, good morning, Jerry. How are you? So let's talk about how do we as salon professionals, because again, this is the group that I'm passionate about, people that are in the beauty salon, barber school, beauty school, suite owner industry. This is my group, okay? How do we get past the YouTube thing? How do we try to combat some of the losses, guys, that I hear I have been basically incurred by YouTube? How do we do that? So this is what I believe, guys. I believe that the only way for us to combat and to get past people using YouTube as a preferential method of getting their hair ideas, getting their makeup ideas, whatever it is that they get, is that we are going to have to out-knowledge them. Now, let me tell you what I mean by out-knowledge. I am a passionate color educator. I teach two things mainly, color seminars and business. That's what I teach. Those are the things that I'm very versed in. I'm passionate about it. That's my lane. I have searched for half a day before, just searching, trying to find information. Now, I'm not talking about techniques and practical approaches to different styles or services, but I'm talking about information about color. I've tried to find really comprehensive or more tutorial-like information about business. I have tried to do this for many years, and I did it once for like half a day. Just trying to find out what can I learn? Okay, if I want to actually go in and if I want to do color, what can I learn other than where to put it on YouTube that will help me be able to have a success? Hi, Ivy, how are you? Be able to have a successful color business. Where on YouTube can I find that? Let me tell you what I realized I couldn't find. I couldn't find how to formulate. I couldn't find how to properly really remove color. I couldn't find anything about how do I do filling. What do I do when the gray doesn't stay? What do I do when I'm trying to think of some color issues, when the red fades off? Or what do I do when the color doesn't happen at all? How do I learn the scientific side of color from YouTube? Somebody, I have searched. If you're able to find that for me, please let me know. And on my search of YouTube, for those of you all that are just coming in, We're having a YouTube conversation and how YouTube has affected our business, many other businesses, and how can we get past that? That's what we're talking about today. Hey, Jana, how are you? That's what we're talking about today. Again, YouTube, guys, it ain't going anywhere. It's not going anywhere. It's going to be here until probably longer than most of us will even be living. Till there's no more computers or internet, and we know that's not happening anytime soon. But what I was stating earlier, for those of you all just chiming in, we have to out-knowledge the people that are coming to sit in our chairs, even stylists that are coming to work at our facilities. We have to out-knowledge them in order to combat what YouTube can teach them. That's what we got to do. And when I say out-knowledge, there's still going to be some stuff that you need to know that YouTube is not going to teach you. There has to be some stuff that you're going to have to know. That means, guys, you know what we're going to have to start doing? Those of us that are industry professionals, we're going to have to start reading some stuff. I know reading stuff is like probably the hardest thing in the world to get creative people to do, is to read. I mean, we can go all the way back to the movie Drumline. Perfect example. He was talented at what he did, but he didn't want to read music. He didn't want to read nothing. He figured he'll just do everything by ear. He'll just do everything on the fly. But in order for him to totally be versed and to be excellent, that's the word, is excellent at what he was doing, he had to know some stuff other than just how to play. Guys, that's what we're going to have to do, guys. We're going to have to learn more about our craft from a theoretic and from a scientific perspective to understand or to be able to combat some of this YouTube university trained group that we're dealing with, from clients all the way to other stylists, in order to combat some of what YouTube has stripped from our industry. I'm gonna tell you, I've been doing this for 30 years, guys. 30 whole years. Actually, it'll be 30 in February. So it's right at that point. And I have never had a problem with helping people understand why you should let me do stuff as opposed to whatever it is that you think you know. And it has nothing to do with my skill set. Now, I do believe I'm a great hairstylist. Technically, I'm great. But I'm going to be honest with you all. I know some little girls that have never seen a beauty school, that could probably sit at home or on their porch, that could probably run circles around me as far as in the technical area, because they just have the gift. They just got it. But they cannot outthink me. They cannot explain something in a way where even the simplest or someone who doesn't even do hair could understand it. They cannot tell you the whys. They cannot tell you why this works. And the one thing, let me tell you, they really can't do is if something go wrong, they have no idea how to fix it. That's the stuff YouTube doesn't teach you. YouTube doesn't teach you what to do when it all goes bad. Okay? Those are the things we have to know. You all have heard me for at least a week and a half now talk about my favorite author, John C. Maxwell. And he says a lot of things in a lot of his different books. I have every single book he's ever written. And he says, those that want to know how to do a thing, I mean, you just want to learn how to cut color weave, that's cool. You'll always have a job. Always. Forever. But those that want to know why will always be your boss. Because the whys will always supersede the hows. The whys, why does color do this? Why does relaxer not work or work at the same time as we do color? Because we actually can't do that now today. But why can't we do it? Why? Not just how. Why can't we do it? The people that know why will always be able to overshadow just the ones that watch YouTube and learn how. Now, I'm going to tell you now. I'm not hating on YouTube now. Don't get me wrong now, because when I can't find something, look, I got to give you this. This is a little sidebar here. I think I was in L.A., and I had rented a Toyota Prius when they first came out. Not first came out, but when they first had the push button starts. Now, this was when push button starts weren't even on as many cars as they are now. So the guys that rented me the car, they didn't tell me once I turned the car off, the whole mechanics to, you know, push, brake, let up, then gear. They didn't tell me none of that, right? So I had to stop and get some gas because they were packed. They said they had to give me a car that didn't have enough gas. Okay, whatever. So I stopped to get some gas, turned the car off, just took the key out, went in to buy some chips or something, pay for the gas, came back out, had no idea how to start this car. Now, this was way, way back when push starts first came out, guys. So I'm sitting in this car asking everybody in the gas station parking lot, do you all know how to start this Prius? Everybody, I got men trying to help me, like, we have no idea. So guess what I did, guys? I went on YouTube. So I'm not hating on YouTube. YouTube walked me through how to start that car. And it was simple. But YouTube can't give me the mechanics. Let's say, for whatever reason, that didn't work. YouTube taught me how. But if I wanted to ask the question, why do cars now start with a push button as opposed to a key? YouTube couldn't explain that to me, though. They could tell me how to do it, but that's it. But let's say I had a problem. Let's say I had something that didn't go right, and the YouTube, whatever they told me, it had some malfunction, or it had something that wasn't working like it was supposed to work. YouTube did not have the knowledge to help me troubleshoot why this may not have worked. And so that's what I'm saying to you all. As far as YouTube goes, yes, you can learn how to balayage, you can learn how to ombre, you can learn, look, I've watched YouTube sometimes, and y'all, I can't even hate. I'd be like, that was really good. That I'm trying to, but that was really good. I got to give it up to whoever just did that. But can I build a business from that? Can I build a business from only knowing how? Because something's going to go wrong. Something is not going to go as expected. And then what am I going to do? Then how do I go to YouTube and say, okay, why didn't the gray take? Why didn't the gray take? Why did her hair fall out in the bowl? Why did her gray hair turn yellow? Why did the color not process at all? Because I don't understand what was already on her hair. When it was there, YouTube is not going to teach you that, guys. It's not. You can forget it. I have searched. But when I make a statement, I try to fact check. I said, you know what? Before I say anything about YouTube, I'm going to sit here and take day after day and every minute that I get in, I'm going to look for it. I'm going to put it in the search engine, see what comes up. Sometimes stuff comes up we know that is not what you're asking for. And guys, I have not found how to formulate. How do you formulate when somebody has gray? How do you formulate when they need a removal process? They need the gray cover. They want to go from a level 2 to a level 10. They want no red in their hair. And their hair has been already previously colored with some stuff on it that they've waited 2 years to color it again now. So now I got all these things, and I got to be able to figure out everything to this equation. YouTube is not going to give me the formula. It's not going to happen. Hey, Eddie, how are you? Me and Eddie, guys, we're coming together. I got to put this addendum out there. This is my partner, Eddie, from Salon Pro Distributors in Atlanta. We're coming together November 5th and 6th. Eddie, you're going to have to put on your comments where they got to go, because I don't remember all that information. I just come and educate. I just do what I do. But November 5th and 6th, we're going to be in Atlanta. We're teaching classes, color. We're teaching you the whys, guys. We got microblading. We got color, we got cutting, we got everything. So Eddie, I have to look, Eddie, Natalie Spencer, that's what you all looking, and I'll be there teaching you the whys. But now back to you group. That's the 5th and 6th, by the way, November 5th and 6th of this year. But back to the whys. YouTube has its place. It does, guys. I'm thankful that when I need to know how to fix something in my house, I am the first one that will say that I am so glad YouTube is around, because YouTube has saved me from a lot of jams. I mean, a lot of jams. But when it comes to our salon professionals and when it comes to our salon industry, you cannot use YouTube to do everything, because what's going to happen? Let me tell you what will happen. YouTube can get you so far. It'll teach you how to do. Hey, Mimi. Speaking of microblading, Mimi, I need my eyelids done. I got my brows done like 20 years ago. I just got them touched up, but I'm gonna need my eyelids done, Mimi. So DM me, Mimi, so I can. I don't have your new number. All right. So back to what I was saying. But again, YouTube has helped me in many cases. Like I said, where I needed to fix things in my house, I needed to figure out how to do whatever it is. But we cannot use YouTube. That's where I was. We cannot use YouTube to build the whole business on, guys. It won't work. Because let me tell you what'll happen. You'll hit a brick wall. You'll hit a brick wall, and YouTube will not be able to save you. You'll have some issues that didn't go as normal. This was a special circumstance. And now you're looking for YouTube to save you. You're looking for, oh my God, what do I do now? What? How do I fix this? This happened. Something happened different. The client lied to me. They didn't tell me they did this. That, how are you going to go on to YouTube now and fix it? How are you going to do it? But if you spend all your time learning from YouTube, and I am saying this now, I'm getting ready to put a blanket statement. Yes, I said it. All of you unlicensed stylists that have learned your craft from YouTube, and I know it's a lot of them out there, and I'm not hating on you. I want you to go to school. I really want you to go to school. I want you to spend the time, the 1,500 hours that me and many others have done. There is something that school really does teach you. It really does, guys. I want you all to just appreciate your craft a little bit more. Let's play fair. And I know some of y'all out there, y'all making money. I get it. Because you done learned it on YouTube. You done learned it wherever you learned it from. But you are going to have an expiration date, guys. You're going to have one. You're going to get to the place you won't be able to attract certain type of customers. You won't be able to have the sustainability that a lot of others of us who have done the work will be able to have. Mark my word. See, I talk to people who are in this position, who are actually in the limelight. They're in the limelight doing their thing. But see, they come to me and they talk to me real because they know I ain't going to tell nobody. And I know they don't have a license. And they're doing their thing. And when we talk one-on-one, I say, you know what? You know I love you. And I sit in no position of judgment. But I want you to do it the right way. I want you to make the investment. I promise you, you ain't got to worry about nobody when they get mad at you, calling on you. Because people call the state on you now. They know you ain't got no license. But do something wrong or piss them off or make them mad or fall out about something. Oh, yeah. I taught beauty school for a little while as just a little side thing to do to help the school out. Oh, it was so many people in there that were in there and have been doing hair forever, but somebody done told on them once, twice, three times because they done fell out with people, and now they got to go do it right or they going to go to jail, okay? They done been fined, all of that. Guys, do it the right way. Do it the right way. YouTube has its place now. I'm not tripping because, I got the YouTube app on my phone. In case I get stuck, I told y'all I couldn't even start that Prius without YouTube. Me and the people that were in the gas station parking lot, we didn't know what to do. We were like, oh, Lord, what happens? That's right, Tanya Wilson Cherry, how you doing? They reach a tipping point, and they can't reach that pivotal move need. That is right. You will hit a wall. Your clientele will go so far. Guys, the goal of being in business is to continually grow until you decide to stop. Not the business cap off and then you just settle for where you are. That shouldn't be. That's never been my goal. I don't know about you all. If I ain't growing, I ain't happy. And I can't go to YouTube and find out everything I need to know to grow. Yeah, you can, like I said, you can find out about the next color technique. And yeah, you can do all of that. I have a YouTube channel. I do things on my YouTube channel to teach you technique. But I'm not going to teach you formulation on YouTube because I'm not going to put it out there. And I'm going to say this to the licensed stylists. I fault you all because you're telling too much to the general public. Quit putting everything on YouTube. Quit putting all of your prized possessions, as they say in the Bible. Don't cast your pearls among swine. All right? You putting all your valuable stuff right on YouTube for the whole world to see it, and then you get mad when they don't want to come to you for the sew-in now. They don't want to come to you. Come to you, why? Why? Come to you, why? Me and my girl can sit there and watch that YouTube video over and over and over again, see how you do the stitch pattern, and I'm talking about the licensed stylists that value what they do. Do not put your information. If you do, you better do it like a trailer to a movie, where I only show you enough, where now you got to pay me for the rest. All right? That's how a movie does. They make those trailers so good, they take the best parts out of the movie, and now we got to go pay to go see it. All right? There you go, Tanya. Free should have a limit. That's right. That's right. Free got to have a limit. You got to pay for information as a client or a stylist or whoever it is. You guys, we're doing this to ourselves, guys. We're doing it to ourselves. I'm sorry. It is what it is. I love y'all, but one thing about Knowledge by Nikki and me, Nikki Smith, I'm going to tell you the truth. And my truth is not coming from just my opinion. My truth is coming from being in this industry, doing hair for 30 years, training all over, even outside of this country, for 20, talking to all kind of people and just listening. I'm just listening to what's happening. And I'm like, okay, how do we fix this? How do we fix this? Okay? Stop giving away. That's right, Mimi. Stop giving away your trade secrets. Stop. You can't give away everything. And don't ever put it nowhere where somebody can go back and look at it. If you're going to be talking and giving away stuff, at least they got to try to recall it. But if you put it on YouTube, all they got to do is go back, push the button again, rewind, fast forward. They got time to study that thing. You're putting yourself out of business. That's what you're doing. You are putting yourself out of business, and you are killing our industry. And I'm only talking about to the people who are licensed, who are putting information out there, who should not be telling unlicensed people everything. Okay, so I gotta keep saying it. Some of you all are just coming in. I am not anti-YouTube. I love YouTube. I got a love-hate relationship with YouTube. That's what I got. I love them and I hate them all at the same time. Okay? But guys, it's not going anywhere. YouTube ain't going anywhere. It's just not. So we have to learn how to combat, how to get past or get around what YouTube is doing. And let me tell you something. The customers that are dependable, this is just from a stylist perspective, if you're still working behind the chair. The customers that are dependable, that are stable, the customers that are the ones that you can bank on as being 20-year people, those customers don't want a YouTube stylist. Those customers they don't watch YouTube like that. They ain't interested. Customers with real money. See, I try to make sure all my customers got extremely busy lives. They all over the place. They don't want to do nothing on their own anyway. I don't even know if they look at YouTube. I have intentionally marketed and made myself acceptable or made myself attractive to a certain type of customers. I want people that's got money. I want people that rarely even ask me how much something costs. They don't even care. Whatever it is, it is. I want people ain't got time to be watching YouTube. I purposely put myself around those kind of people. I swear, every now and again, it almost shocks me when people say, how much was that? Because they rarely do. It has to be something maybe like real different than what they used to. And they ain't asking because they tripping. They just asking like, oh, okay, I just wondering. They don't really care. My people ain't got time to watch YouTube. I got people that own businesses and property and real estate. Them jokers ain't trying to do their own hair. They ain't going to nobody's house getting their hair done. They don't care. They want somebody who's going to do it and do it right. That's what they want. They don't want nothing else. And those are the kind I want. So if you got the type of clients that want a YouTube girl to do the $50 sew-in, then let me tell you what you got to change. Not only do you have to gain more knowledge, but you're going to have to change you. Because whether you know it or not, you attract your own kind. You attract what you are. If you a fly-by-nighter and you just basically all over the place and you kind of have this cheap mentality. I can't even think of the word I'm really looking for. But you have this mentality that whatever, you're going to get what you are. I promise you. If you unstable, if you one day this way, next, you're going to get wishy-washy people just like you. People who don't necessarily have the means to pay on a regular basis. So what do? When they can't pay you, they go right to YouTube and figure out what you're doing. Also, when it comes to using professional products, you need to use professional products, stuff they can't Go on YouTube. Stuff. Y'all know I'm an Amazon lover now, so I'll have an Amazon conversation later. But I was going to say stuff they came back off Amazon, but I don't even know what you came back off Amazon today. I just don't know. It seemed like you could buy everything off Amazon. All right? But there are still some things that have not been diverted, and you cannot buy off of Amazon. So you're going to have to find a way to reinvent yourself where you ain't attracting the people who want to learn how to do it on YouTube and nickel and dime you for the things that they're getting, because on YouTube, the girl doing it, it only costs $50. I ain't worried about no $50 weave shop. I'm not worried about it. I ain't trying to compete with them. I'm not trying to compete with nobody that's charging $50 for something that, if it takes up more than 30 minutes of my time, is worth more than $50. I'm not doing that. I've invested too much in my education, in everything. See, I have put it all on the line. I have had to lose to get here. And I'm talking about lose everything and regain it to get here. And I am not competing. I will not be put in a position where if you don't want to pay it, deuces. There are people out here that will pay what you're worth. They are. But you have to make sure you're worth it. And all of us got blind spots now. All of us sometimes thinks we're bigger than we are. Ask some people around you. They'll tell you. I do that every now and again. I ask my customers, why do you still come here 20 years later? Because, see, I can take it. Now, make sure you're emotionally mature enough to handle them possibly saying something you don't like. Okay, so you got to be, if it's a hint, you got to be able to take it. But you need to ask people, why do you still come here? Year after year after year after year. Or if you're not retaining customers, maybe YouTube got them. So it's something you doing that makes them find other reasons to get their hair done. Other than, that's right, emotional intelligence, Tanya. There's a book. I have it. I've had it for years off emotional intelligence. I'll find out the author. I'll tell you all later, because I got a bookshelf full of books. I do audiobooks and books. But you have to be able to create the type of clientele for those that are owners. I told you last week about creating the type of environment you want for the type of stylist that you bring it into your culture. But all of us got to be anti-YouTube when it comes to us putting all of our business on the line for the whole world to learn how to do exactly what we do. What they need you for then? What they need you for? But again, they cannot get the knowledge. They cannot get the knowledge of how to fix stuff, of how to combat problems. They cannot learn the real stuff that we deal with in the salon on YouTube. They can't get it, y'all. And so I challenge you all, because I'm almost out of time. I challenge you all, start reading more. You can go, now this is where you can go on Amazon. Amazon has all types of books on, I got one, I'll give this one to you. I've had it for years. It's the M'lady, I think it's called the Hair Product Ingredient Glossary or Dictionary. I bought it forever ago. It helped me understand why all shampoos aren't equal. I literally was able to break every single component down in shampoo, in conditioner, in relaxers, in all of these things. And it gave me such a deep understanding why this relaxer doesn't work like this one. And why this, I said, oh, okay. You think I could even learn that on YouTube? You think YouTube doing all that? YouTube ain't doing all that. That's right. Say it again, Mimi. Neiman Marcus don't care nothing about what Kmart is doing. They say, if you want Kmart, you go to Kmart. I've actually used that analogy, Mimi, but I've used it with Nordstrom's and Kohl's. Okay? Same analogy. So, guys, we got to get it together. Our industry is not dead. And as long as I'm breathing, 30 years later, I still love what I do. I love what I know it could be. I have seen it shift, but I am committed to the day God says I can no longer speak. The book is the M'lady Product Ingredient Glossary or Dictionary. I bought it forever ago. So it says hair product ingredient glossary. I think that's what it says, or dictionary. But again, every hair product you can pick up. This is from Nikisha. She's asking me what the book is again. Every hair product you can get, turn it over, read the stuff on the back, go in that book. You will see what all these extremely long, retarded words mean. You're like, oh, I get it now. Okay, who is this? Aisha Hammonds, I'm going to read what you said. Y'all see, I got my new glasses, y'all. How y'all like my new glasses? I can see now. Praise God. I manage a beauty school and I am showing this to students Okay, these for Sierra Farm, up too close. I tell them this all the time. Thanks, pretty lady, with pleasure. Where I was going is I'm going to use my voice to help rebuild this industry until the day I hang up my blow dryer and say I'm done, and then I'm going to keep talking. As long as God gives me a voice, which the devil tried to take it 1 year, God, but I'll tell y'all about that later. That was with my cancer. They told me I'd never talk again. I said, okay. I wasn't worried about it, but that's another time, another day, okay? But as long as I have a voice, I am going to be on the horn for people to understand that this business is not lost. It hurts me when I see people who started with me who are now basically saying that I had to go get another job somewhere else because I just couldn't make it. It just wasn't working for me anymore. And I'm talking about people that were doing it for years. It breaks my heart. And it's not that it doesn't work. Yes, it has changed. I will tell anybody in the world, it has changed. But we got to change too. Hey, Ebony, love you back, baby. We got to change too. Look, Ebony, that's my ride or die, y'all. Everywhere I go, Ebony's there. I love her for it. We got to change too. Coming from the old school, let me tell y'all something. It's hard sometimes to change. It's because you like, no, I'm going to do this. I'm going to do this the way I've been doing it. Well, the way you've been doing it didn't work. Some of my friends in the industry can tell you, I was so anti, I'm not doing all that social media stuff. That's like another job for me. That's like, when I started doing Facebook Live, guys, I have never had so much fun in my life. I don't know what I was waiting for. And God, I got a lot to say. I got so much in this brain of mine. And I am willingly. Now, of course, obviously, I can only give y'all some stuff. Y'all going to have to pay for the rest now. Because I got books. I got all kind of stuff. And I'm going to tell y'all about that as I go. For those of you all logging on, I do this every morning, Monday through Friday. I don't fool with y'all Saturday and Sunday. From 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Somebody real quick, type that up on the screen for me so people will know. This is what I do. And it's just, you're just talking with me. Talking with Nikki Smith. My company is Knowledge by Nikki. And I really want us to get it. I want us to get it. Thank you, Ebony. I appreciate you so much. Since day one of her career, I've been a jewel to her, and I appreciate you. I do not take it for granted that just because I've been here that I have to stay where you all want me. I have to make sure I stay relevant. Thank you, Stacy. I have to make sure I stay relevant. I have to make sure that I understand what it all that you are talking about. I started with Deli and it changed. Thank you. Praise God. That's Mitch Michelle. But it's 7:30, guys. And y'all know I do hair only 2 days a week, Thursday and Friday. Today is the day. Hey, Monica in Cleveland. Hey, honey. We got, me and Monica been getting together for years. We gonna do this. Monica, I'm doing a salon owners conference. I'll call you. As long as your number hasn't changed, I'll call you. It's going to be in Las Vegas, guys. It's going to be at the Stratosphere Hotel at the end of next year. This is where you can come and get all the pearls that YouTube can't teach you. But, guys, I got to go. I really got to go. I do 50 things before I start work. So, you all, I'll see you all tomorrow. Same time, 7 to 7:30. 7 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Friday. We always got a new subject. I let God give me whatever it is that he gives me. And I just hope you all are enjoying it. One day we're going to have us a radio show, guys. It's going to be just Salon Talk Radio. Okay? I'm working on that. All right? But I got to go, babies. So peace out. I'll see you tomorrow, 7 o'clock.